is dealt in a functions, what we need to do is we need to write two different functions, one for accepting the data, one for displaying the data. Okay, it will be similar to this. What changes I am going to make, kindly pay attention, because you'll have to complete this particular code. You have to write two functions. One is, let me write the main first. Okay, let me write the main. Where is it? Yeah. So R is equal to enter the number of columns, C is equal to number of columns, matrix is equal to blank. What is this accept? Accept is a function which is going to accept the data. So we pass the parameter matrix, number of rows, number of columns. Display is a function that is going to display the contents of the matrix. R is a number of rows, C is a number of columns. And here, what should I do? I should write two functions. Which are the two functions? Accept and display. So how I should write accept function? Void accept. How many parameters we have? Three. Matrix, R, comma C. Okay, you'll be writing the code for this. Another function name is def display, again matrix, R, comma C, and this is going to display the content. Okay, so kindly write a code which will accept the data into this matrix and display the contents of the matrix. It is similar to my previous question. Okay, only you have to write the code in the function. Is the question clear to you? Is the question clear to everyone? You're supposed to write the code for accept and display in two user defined function. Have you understood it? So try completing these two functions. Okay, I hope you have done it. What was expected from you was something like this. You should directly copy this particular code, which was this one. Okay, and paste it over here. You come here. This is to the right, this is to the right, this is over here. And instead of M, it will be the matrix, since you have passed the matrix as a parameter. And then for the display, this particular data, which was over here, should be pasted here. And this will be here, and here, and here. Yeah. So normally what we do is we break the functionality and put it in a different function. We break the functionality and put it in a different function. So this is R, this is C, we are passing R and C, control comes over here. Here I made R and C as lowercase, so this won't give any error. Here you are supposed to accept the data, here you are supposed to append the data, and then you are supposed to display the data. Instead of M, it should be matrix. And let's run the code and check it whether it's working or not. Enter number of rows 2, number of columns 3. Now what would happen? This particular call is being made to the accept function. So let's take the value as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And after we enter the data, what we do? We should display the contents. We should display the content. That means now what should happen? It should come over here and display the content. So let's see what happens when I do something like this. 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3 is the content of the first row. 4, 5, 6 is the content of the second row. It displays the value and then it stops. So in this case, matrix R and C, display. What is a mistake over here? Except. List index out of range. Matrix IJ for J in C. List index is out of range. Row is 2. This one is C. So R and C. Matrix. We entered 2 rows, 3 columns. We accepted the data. Appended over here. Control came back. We made a call to the display. It was matrix row for I in range, for J in range C. Print matrix I comma J and this is over. And then it displays I comma J comma this one for I.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, matrix what up? वो अपने फॉर लूप के बाहर लिखे
कौन सा
सर def except matrix rc वाला जो है ना इसमें फॉर लूप
अच्छा वो बाहर लिखा है
हां यस सर
ओके गॉट इट Okay, so one indentation will not make the code match out over here. What had happened was, I have pulled this over here. Because of this, what happened was, only this was added out over here. Okay, that means in the same range 1 2 3 was overwritten with 4 5 6, and then when it came over here it displayed only the 4 5 6, not the 1 2 3. And since it had got only one row and three column, so when it was trying to access this particular contents, it was giving me range out of index when I was 1. So this I had placed it over here, it should have been inside. Similarly for the print, it shouldn't have been here, it should have been here, so that I get the correct output. Here for example, I'm not getting 4 5 6 on the next line. Kindly keep this program with you, because the next one will be the extension of this. Now let's copy it. Let's find out sum of each row. Okay, let's have the same code, but we'll make one more call now. Sum of each row, and I'll pass the same parameter, matrix R comma C. And let me tell you what I want in this particular function. So assume that we had, let me put a comment. Let's assume we have entered the specification, two rows and one, three columns. Let's assume we have entered 1 2 3 and 4 5 6. So what I want is sum of each row. That means it should give me the sum as 3 2 1, which is 6, and then it should give me 4 5 11, 6 plus 4 4 plus 5 9, 9 plus 6 15. It should give me this particular output. So my output should be, if I enter this particular data, my output should be, it should be displaying this particular data first of all, which is already done because we already written the code for accept as well as display. Now what I need is sum of each row. That means I need additionally this particular output, that is addition of each of these particular elements and then sum of this particular elements. So as soon as the sum of the first row is over, you should display it and again reset sum back to zero. If you don't do it, then what will happen? This 6 will be taken as it is, 4 will be added, it becomes 10, then 5 will be added, it becomes 15, 15, 6 will be added, it becomes 21, which will be the wrong. So for each and every row, sum should be reset back to zero and you should find the sum. So kindly do it, kindly write a code. That means you'll have to write a code for sum of each row. Matrix R. Okay, try to complete this code. 2 to 3 minutes, it shouldn't take more than 3 minutes. Any doubts till now? Okay, let's check out some contents. Sum of row for I in range R, sum is equal to 0. For J in range A, sum plus equal to matrix of IJ, print sum. Good. Good. What I will do is remove this. What I said was you should declare a sum, okay? Then display a helpful message for finding the sum of each row. Not required. What was required was this particular loop. For I in range R, for J in range C, sum plus equal to ARR of IJ. Okay. So what will happen in this case is it will find the sum. As soon as the inner loop is over, what it should do? It should display helpful message. The sum of the row is equal to so and so sum. That means it will display sum of the row 0 is sum. Now I told you that after the first loop is over, what you should do? You should reset the sum. So what I am doing, as soon as the inner loop is over, I do sum equal to 0. So when we go back over here for the outer loop, what should happen? It should reset back the sum to 0, and then it should be in a position to find the sum of the next row. Let's try to run this. Number of rows 2, number of columns 3. Let's enter 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the original content, and then it says finding sum of each row, and then it gives me an error. Then it gives me an error. Okay, so let's see what is the error over here. Sum plus equal to ARR of IJ. Now, what do we have an ARR? We don't have an ARR. So what we should do? I have made a mistake over here. It should have been matrix. Okay, it should have been matrix. Or another way, what should I do? I should simply copy this, paste it over here. That means I change this to ARR. Okay? Either you can have it as M, matrix, ARR, whatever you want. It should be in a position to display it. Keep the cursor over here, run it again. 2 rows, 3 columns. And then it comes over here and displays sum of row 0 is 16, sum of row 1 is 15. Now kindly pay attention over here. It is giving me the correct sum. 3 plus 2 plus 1 is 6, 4 plus 5 plus 6 is 15. And actually, this is not row 0. It should have been row 1. This is actually the index. Yes or no? This is an index. What is the index of the first row? 0. What is the index of the second row? 1. So what I want is, I wanted something like this. Sum of row 1 is 6. Sum of row 2 is 15. So make the changes in this particular program so that I want the correct output. I want sum of row 1 is so and so. Sum of row 2 is so and so. You'll have to make changes in the print line. What is that change? You have to write it down. Giving you 1 minute. Yes, it should have been I plus 1. So the changes we need is simply have to say I plus 1. Understood? Good. Now, what I want is, so we got the output as, let me write it over here, sum of row 1 is And next I want is sum of each column. That means now what it should do, it should display sum of column 1 is 4 plus 1, 1 plus 4, that is 5. Sum of column 2 is 2 plus 5, that is 7. Sum of column 3 is 6 plus 3, 9. So I want you to design a function that should display the sum of each and every column. So what I will do, I will come over here, copy this function, and over here I will say sum of each column. The rest will be the same. And over here, this I will change it to sum of each column. Copy it, paste it, paste it. Okay, and you write a code which should find the sum of each column. Kindly pay attention. When I say sum of each column, kindly pay. See, 1 plus 4, 2 plus 5, 3 plus 6. Understood? That means the inner loop should be running how many times? 2 times, because I want a sum of 1 and 4, then 2 and 5, then 3 and 6. That means outer loop should be running how many times? 3 times. And the inner loop should be running 2 times. So make the changes in this particular program. We'll give you 2 minutes. So let's check out the solution, whether you have been in a position to do it or not. So what I did in the outside, you said C. Okay, good. In the outside, you said R. C and then R. C and then R. C and then R. Yes. Good. we look over here in the outside loop, we have to say C because we want to execute it three number of times, and the inner loop should be executed twice, so we say R. And if you look over here, it shouldn't be ij, it should be ji, because we are saying for j in row, that means first row, second row, again first row, second row, this has to be done how many times? Three times. And over here I will say sum of the column I plus 1. Anyone has any doubt in this? Because the next example you will have to do on your own. Since I have taught you how to accept the data, how to display the data, how to find the sum of each row, how to find the sum of each column, the next example, you have to do it on your own. If you have any questions, kindly raise it now. Okay. Now, the next question. The maximum and minimum of list. Okay. This is a sample input. Two rows, three columns. I've entered 10, 20, 30, 100, 2, and 80. So what it should do? It should display the max as 100, min as 2. Okay. I want this particular output. What is given to you? What is given to you is this particular part of the program, that is one to accept the data and to display the data. So that is given to you. Then we don't need a display, we need something else. What we need to do, we need to display max and min. Okay, we need to display max and min. So chain this function, display max and min. And here you write the code which will display the maximum and minimum over here. Okay, no need of a print. You have to do something else. Write the code for something else for display maximum and minimum. Giving you 2 to 3 minutes. Okay, let's check out display max and min. Okay, work in progress. Take the first element as max and min. Let's check it out whether you have written the code. You took the max as minus 99, you took the min as so and so, and written the code. Okay. So, what you have to do is take max as matrix of 0, 0. Let the first element be maximum and let the first element also be minimum. Okay. And then what you'll have to do? Check if the brackets are correct. If matrix of ij is greater than max, what we should do? We should say max equal to matrix of I and j. Okay. But there won't be if else. For each and every element, we have to find the max as well as min. So now I will write if matrix of I and j is less than the minimum value, then my minimum value will be equal to matrix I. Well, I should write this correctly. It looks neat. And as soon as both the loops are over, right? What we should do? We should say print max equal to max comma. Mistake, max equal to max comma minimum equal to min. Let's try to run this and see whether it works. Oh, made a mistake again. Two rows, three columns, 10, 50, 80, 100, 4, and 2. What is maximum? 100. What is minimum? It's 2. Clear? Understood? Not write LCF, because if you write LCF, then you are going for each and every element, you are going to check only the maximum or minimum. I wanted both to be checked. That's why you have to write independent if, not if elif. Is it clear to you, everyone? Have you understood it? Yes or no? Just type yes or no so that I can give you the next assignment. Okay, thank you. Now, first step, if I do something like this, what will happen? Let's see. I change my indentation. Two rows, three columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What it will do? It will display maximum and minimum of each row, right? No, it displays maximum of the first row, which is 3, maximum of the second row, and minimum of the first. So if you want to find the maximum and minimum of each of the rows, then you will have to do certain changes. And what is the changes you have to do? You have to tell me. I need to find the maximum and minimum of each row. I want to find the maximum and minimum of each row, not of the all. So the changes we have to make is something like this. Copy this, paste it. Since you're dealing with the maximum and minimum of each and every row, check the indentation. And over here, it will be I. That means for each and every row, kindly check the maximum and minimum. And let's remove this. Let's try to run this. Two rows, three columns. 1, 5. And what's the maximum? 5, minimum is 1. And the second row, 10, 40, and 0. What is the maximum? 40 and 0. What is finding? Maximum of the first row is 5, minimum is 1. For the next one, maximum of the first row is 40, minimum is 0. So in case you need to find the maximum and minimum of each row, then kindly put this inside the loop and put an I over here. Do not put a 0. I means what? For each and every row, it will take the first element as a maximum and minimum. It will take it as a maximum and minimum. Is it clear? Any doubts you have? Okay. Now, I do not want, let me copy this, paste it. Yes, I have printed it. Now what I want you to do is, I don't want to print this value. Yeah, I want to return this value. I want to return this value. That means I want to return the maximum and minimum, not of the each row, but the final value. So over here, I will say return max and min. And I will pull this outside. So here I will have to say return max and min. And correspondingly on the left hand side, I will have to write max comma min equal to. Is it compulsory that it should be the same variable name? No. You could very well say largest and smallest. And then I will display L. if say largest value is equal to L, smallest is equal to S. Do, please pay attention. I'm not printing the value. I'm returning it. Let's see. Two rows, three columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Indentation does not match. Return max, return min, ln r. Display max and min, ln r return. Return max and min will return the value to LNS and it will display the largest and the smallest value. So you should be aware that we could return more than one value. You could return more than one value. You have been told to write a program which will display the sum of the diagonal elements, sum of the square matrix, diagonal elements of the square matrix. Square matrix means what? The matrix in which the number of rows and columns are same. So in case I enter 3, means it is 3 by 3. If I enter 4, it means 4 by 4. Yeah, so only accept one value. And let's assume we have entered these values. This is for display. Now what I want is, I want to find the sum of the diagonal. So it will be 1 plus 5 plus 9, that is 6, 15. Some of the other diagonal will be 5 plus 6, 6 plus 9. Some of the other one will be 7 plus 5, that will be 12, 12 plus 3 is 16. Understood? What we should do? We should write a function. Let's write the function here only. Sum of the first diagonal S1, sum of the another diagonal S2, and let's call the function as display sum of both diagonals, sum of both diagonal, and pass the value matrix comma R comma C. I want you to write a function which will find the sum of both the matrix, sum of both the diagonals. Clear? Complete this particular function which will return the sum of both the diagonal elements. Come on, find it out. So let me check if any solutions are being tested. Through matrix sum two for I in range, for J in range, if I equal to so and so, good. If I plus J equal to C, wonderful. Sum plus two equal to matrix of IJ. Sum of first diagonal is sum one, sum of diagonal two is sum two. It's good, Dhruv. But do return the value. So you should say return sum one comma sum two, so that it is finding, it is returning the both the sums. Wonderful. Is my coding ninja screen visible to you? Is my coding ninja screen visible to you? Okay, fine. For a given two-dimensional integer array of list, you need to find out which row or column has the largest sum. That means sum of all the elements in a row and column, amongst all the rows and columns. So let's see what they mean by this. So what they are saying is something like this. There is one test case, okay, with two rows and two columns. With two rows and two columns, and they have the sample input as 1, 1 and 1, 1. Okay. So which row has got the maximum sum? They are saying it is row 0, 2. So let me check out how they got the row. For each test case, if the row sum is maximum, then print row index and the row sum. Okay, or if the column index is maximum, then print column index and column sum. Look at the output format. For each test case, if the row sum is maximum, then display row along with the row index and the row sum. If it is for column index, display the column index and the column sum. So if you take this into consideration, what they are saying is for the row 0, what is the sum? It is 2. For the row 1, okay, what is the sum? It is 2. But whichever is found first, you should be giving it. You should be giving that particular sum. Anything else they have said? In case both are same? Nothing has been said. Okay. To understand it better, let's take the next test case. How many test cases are there? 2. The first test case has got how many rows and columns? 3 and 3. What are the content? 3, 6, 9, 1, 4, 7, and 2, 8, 9. Okay. So what they are saying is, what is the output in the first case? In the first case, it is column 2 has got a maximum sum 25. Let's see. What is this? 9 plus 6 plus 3, that is 15 and 3, 18. Okay. So 7 plus 4, 11, 11 plus 1, 12. Okay. 9 plus 8, 17, 17 plus 2, 19. That means if you compare all these three rows, which one has got a maximum sum? The third row has got a maximum sum. Okay. Because it has got 9, 8, which is 17 plus 2, 19. Okay. Let's remember this particular row 0, row 1, row 2. That means row 2 has got a maximum value. Now let's take the column wise case. 3, 1, 2, no. 6, 4, 8, 8 plus 4 is 12, 12 plus 4 is 16, which is less than the last value of 19, no. 9, 7, 9, 9 plus 7 is 16, 16 plus 9 is 25. Is it greater than this? Yes. So column 0, column 1, column 2. So this particular column has got the maximum sum, has got the maximum sum. So it should say column 2 has got the maximum value and the sum is 25. And the sum is 25. In the next case, what they are saying, there are 4 rows and 2 columns. 1, 2, 90, 100, 3, 40, minus 10 and 200. Okay. So if you find the sum of this, it is 3, 90 and 100, 190, 3 and 40, 43, minus 10 and 200, 190. Okay. So let's take this row. This sum is 190. This sum is again 190. So take this one. So which is this row? This is the row 1. Okay. Now let's take the column. 193 minus 10. No. 240, 200, 240, 340, and 342. So this column has got the highest value, which is the column 1, which is the 342. So is the question clear to you? Is the question clear to you? Okay. Now what they are saying is, kindly write only the function code. If you look over here in the Coding Ninjas code, okay, do not be bothered about this particular code. Okay. This is the optimized code for the computer, for CP. We call it as a competitive coding, which will be clear to you only when you render once you complete the data structure. So instead of that, you can take my input, whereas to simply accept the data into rows and column and accept the data. What they want you to find is this particular function. you have to write down the function which will find the largest of it. Okay, that means how many parameter it takes: arr, rows and columns. Clear? So let me see what program I have written for this. Okay, now I hope my Jupyter 2D list is open to you, and let's try to analyze this particular code, right? It says how many rows we have, threes. How many columns we have, threes. That means this is three, this is columns. I have taken the minimum value as -214. What is this value actually? I have taken some minimum value which is available for an integer. Okay, you could have taken some other values based on the input. If they are saying that the input will be positive values only, you could have taken it as -1. Okay, you could have taken it as -1. If the array has got a minimum as well as maximum value, then take this particular number, which is nothing but the minimum value for a 32-bit system. Minimum value for 32 bits. Okay, I have taken this concept from C++ or Java, where minimum is taken as a 4 bytes. Now, in case of find the largest, kindly pay attention with me when I do the dry run of this. Is row equal to true? Make it as true. Largest sum is equal to minimum value. Okay, so largest sum will be the minimum. Num equal to 0. For I in range, number of rows. How many rows we have? We have what? 3 rows. Okay, so what I'm doing over here, this code is basically finding out the index which has got the maximum one. This is going to find out which particular column has got the highest one. For I in range number of rows, row sum is equal to 0. For j in range number of columns, so what I'm doing over here, I'm saying what is the value of I? 0. Okay, what is the value of j? 0. So what I'm saying over here is find a row sum. Okay, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2. That means what will be the sum in this case? It will be 15. It will be the 15. Is a row sum greater than the largest sum? What is the largest sum? -214. Yes. So what I do, I say num is equal to I. I do not store the largest sum. Kindly pay attention. I only assign the value of row sum to largest sum, and I'm using num is equal to I. That means what is the value of num now? The I, which is 0. That means 0th row has got a maximum value. Done. Again, I come over here. What is the value of I? 1. What is the value of j? 0. So now find 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2. What is the sum? 7 plus 4, 11. 11 plus 1. 12. See, row sum is again initialized. So the sum will be 12. Is it greater than the largest sum? No. So skip this. This won't be executed. Okay. Then the next value is 289. 8 plus 2, 10. 10 plus 9, 19. What was the previous sum? It was 18. Is this greater than this? Yes, it is greater. So what will happen? This will be true. So what is row sum? It is greater than the largest sum. Largest sum is equal to 8 plus 2, 19 it is. Num is equal to I. So what is the value of num? It is 2. Are these rows over? Yes. So kindly pay attention. Is row was true initially. This was true. Clear. And what had happened over here is num is equal to 2. Now I do it for the columns. I do it for the columns. Okay. For I in range number of rows, For sorry, for j in number of columns, then for j in number of rows, what I do? I find the sum of this 3, 1, 2. So what is the sum in this case? 3 plus 1 is 4, 4 plus 2 is 6. Understood? So I find a column over here. Then what I do? I check whether this column sum is greater than the largest sum. But my largest sum was 19. 3 plus 1 plus 2 is not greater than that. So what I do? I don't enter into this. Okay, I don't enter into this. Next value is 6 plus 4, 10, 10 plus 8 is 18. Is this greater than the largest sum, which is 19? No. I go back over here. 9 plus 7 is 16, 16 plus 9 is 25. Is it? Yes. So what I do, I say column sum is equal to largest sum, which is 25. Num is equal to j. So which was a j over here? It was 2. And then I say is row equal to false. That means row doesn't have the maximum value. It is a column which is having the maximum value. Then what I do, I use this particular if condition. If is row, what do you mean by this? If is row is true, but is row is false because of this condition. So this won't be executed. So what will happen? It will come in the else part and it will display this particular column, which is 2, has got a largest sum. Has got a largest sum. I hope it is clear to you. Let me go back to my coding. Is this code clear to you? Is this code clear to you? Let me copy this for you. I will have to copy it in the step by step. Let me take you, comment this out. Comment this out. It's my code, not this. Is a minimum value there? Define minimum, define this is row, is column. Let's take this custom input. Let me share my screen again. So it's saying column 2, 25, column 1, 3, 40. Is it matching? Yes, it is matching. Let me click on the submit button. One test case is missing. No, I got it right. I got it right. All the six test cases are clear. Okay. So this code is working. Kindly make a note of it. Any doubt in this particular question? No. So this particular wave print and spiral print are there. Okay. I'll explain one of them, which is a wave print. Spiral print you will have to do on your own. I'll give you one complete day. Okay. And after that, what you're going to, after completing the wave print, immediately I'm going to start tomorrow. I guess you have the exam. Okay. So by today evening or tomorrow morning, tomorrow you have the Python exam, right? FA2. Okay. So morning, you will get a link, exam link along with the date and time, along with the time. It is, I guess, 12:30 to 1:30, I guess. Okay. Let me just confirm it in the morning and I will send you the, sorry, your mentors will send the link. Clear? Do well in that particular exam. Understood? Just give me a moment for taking the attendance. I guess webcam is compulsory. Roll number, answer your roll call 1127. One 162, 1220, 1239, 1249. One 250. One 251. Noted, Aman. 1251, Meenakshi. 1252, Aryan. 1253. 1254. 1255, 1256. 1257, 1258. 1259, 1260. 1261, 1262. 1263, 1265. 1266, 1267. 1268, 1269. 1270, 1271. 1272, 1273. 1274, 1275. 1276, 1277. 1278, 1279, 1280. 1281, 1283. 1285, 1286. 1288, 1289, 1290. 1292, 1293, 1294. 1295, 1296, 1297. 1298, 1299, 301. 302, 303, 304, 305, 3004, Tarun, 3014, 5039, 5039, 5042, 5044, 5045, 5046, 5047, 5048, 5049, 5051. Anyone name I have missed out? Anyone who has missed out in the attendance, let me just note. Avinash, 1249. Okay, noted. Muskan, 1263, noted. Divyanshi is already present. Gaurav is already present. 5049, done. Okay. All the best for your exam tomorrow. Okay. The link will be shared tomorrow morning. Whatever is it, there is a revision document, go through it. Okay. It's there in the notes section. Yes, 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 Dhruv. You are free to use pen and paper to do some rough work and then you can write down the solution. Absolutely no issues with that. Will it be conducted on Coding Ninja? Yes. Python is always going to be conducted on Coding Ninjas and IWT is going to be conducted on MyMapIt. Any other doubts you have? No? Okay then. End of the session. Thank you. We'll be meeting tomorrow. Yes, Amrit. What is the query? Doubt in highest occurring character. Which is this question? In which one? Strings, two dimensional list, tuples, searching, sorting, where it is? In strings. Okay, I'll have a look at it. You send me your code. Let me check it where it is failing. Okay. Waveprint will be taken tomorrow. Waveprint will be taken tomorrow. As far as strings is concerned, I think you should wait or send me your solution so that I can check it. But it will take at least a day for me to figure it out. Okay. Because I am tied up with some other batch. No, don't paste it over here. Mail it to me. Okay.